In this video, we're computing the interference and diffraction minima and maxima for 532 nanometer green laser light passing through a pair of slits with a separation of 0.15 millimeters, with that interference pattern projected onto a screen 3 meters away from the slits. So this big D in the diagram, that's 3 meters. And really what we're doing here is just quoting the formulas that we've already derived for interference minima and maxima and diffraction minima. And I'll just post links to those videos as they come up. In part A, we're asked for the location of the first interference minimum relative to the central bright spot on the screen. So the way this formula turned out is d sine theta is equal to n plus a half times the wavelength lambda, where n is 0, 1, 2, and so on. That little d is the slit separation, so that's 0.15 millimeters for us. And we're plugging in n equals 0, that gives us the first minimum. That's where the path length difference for the two rays arriving at that point on the screen is equal to 1/2 of a wavelength. So we're plugging in n equals 0, and we're going to make an approximation that gives us this value y, the distance between the center line and that first interference minimum. The approximation we make for small angles is that sine theta is approximately equal to tangent theta, which is just y over big D. Making that substitution, I get little d y over big D equals 1/2 lambda. Solving for y, I get big D lambda over 2 little d. Now we just substitute the values for all of these things and get everything in the right units of meters as we go. Nanometers are 10 to the negative 9 meters. 0.15 millimeters is 0.00015 meters. And I get 0.00532 meters, which I could write as 5.32 millimeters. In part B, I want the location of the first interference maximum relative to the central bright spot on the screen, and the way this formula turned out, and again, I'll post a link to it as I go, is d sine theta is equal to n lambda, where n is 0, 1, 2, and so on. Now, n equals 0 corresponds to an angle of theta equals 0 here. In other words, that's the central maximum. That's not what we're interested in. We're interested in the n equals 1 maximum, the first one that's off the center line. And again, we make the small angle approximation. The sine theta is approximately tangent theta, which is y over big D. So we get little dy over big D equals lambda, and we solve for y again. And we sub in the values for all of these variables. And to get 0.0106 meters, which could be written as 10.6 millimeters. Finally, in part C, we're asked to consider the width of the slits themselves. Each slit has to have some finite width, and we already know that a slit with a finite width is going to produce a diffraction pattern. So whenever we look at interference in the lab, we're actually looking at interference and diffraction at the same time. And we're asked for the location of the first diffraction minimum, so where the slit width itself is causing the intensity of the light to go to zero. This diffraction minimum is going to suppress the interference pattern. And again, I'll just post a link to the video where this was derived. It turned out that our diffraction minima occur where A sine theta, that's where A is equal to the slit width, is equal to N lambda, where N is 1, 2, 3, and so on. So we just plug in the slit width. And again, we make the small angle approximation. Sine theta is approximately tangent theta, which is Y over D. And we sub in N equals 1 for the first diffraction minimum off the center line. And we get Y equals lambda D over the slit width A. Sub everything in the right units. I just tacked on 3 zeros to turn the millimeters into meters. Into 3 sig figs, I get 0.0200 meters, which I could write as 20.0 millimeters. So this is the first point where the diffraction pattern is going to suppress the interference pattern to zero. And we'll see our series of bright dots for interference fade out at that point. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.